find ourselves at the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, for this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Just a short time ago, sounds loud enough to reverberate across the Rockies. They're ready for football in Denver as the Broncos get set to do battle with the Buffalo Bills.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
And off we go from Denver. And this carries into the end zone. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. The Bills make their way out, led by their third-year quarterback from Wyoming. At 24 years of age, it's Josh Allen.
I think the development of Josh Allen as a starting quarterback in Buffalo has been rapid. We knew he had a big arm coming out of college. People question his accuracy, his decision-making a little bit. I think that continues to improve as well. And the biggest surprise, how well he's used his legs to give them an extra dimension in the running game. And give him credit, his completion percentage last season was up 6 points from the year before. He continues to improve.
4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 16 carries, 62 yards. And they see right through that defensively. As he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield.
Watching the film, we saw that things clicked pretty well for them in the running game last week. No reason to change in my mind. Continue to try and run the football, give it to him early and often in hopes of breaking down the defense so some bigger gains result as the game goes on.
Throwing is Allen on third. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Bradley Chubb in there to get him, and on the season now that is 9 sacks for him.
And that's their first sack of this game, but how about last week? 6 sacks, great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
And returning it, here's Hamler. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And it'll be a short field for the Broncos as they take over first and 10. So now here are the Broncos with excellent field position to start off. They'll be led out by their quarterback in his second season out of Missouri, Drew Locke.
And I thought in last week's game, he found a way to win like a good pitcher without his best stuff. I mean, he did throw 2 interceptions, offset by 1 touchdown pass. Not the ratio, not the numbers you're really looking for as a QB. But finding a way to win, that's all that really matters.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
At the 25-yard line.
Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number 3 man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching a football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to 17.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3.
On 2nd down, they'll run with Gordon. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. A couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more.
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Melvin Gordon, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos have taken the early lead. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the
This will make it into the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25-yard line.
So here come the Bills out for their second drive as we grind toward the end of the season here. And they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, they've drafted multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stopped up front. And as a GM, that always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league. And big people always end up winning games for you.
Now this throw caught left side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
First down, Buffalo.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
Second and 12. How about that, partner? That happened in a hurry. Sudden, explosive, gets into the backfield and spills the play.
Yeah, he was AFC Defensive Player of the Week last week because of trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
A look at the numbers a week ago for Lindsey. 19 carries, 71 yards, and a touchdown. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
Well, he's the number 2 runner in the league, and you just know the offensive line wants to get him to number 1 because most of the good ball carriers, they take care of their linemen. Could be a gold watch in their future if he becomes the leading rusher.
And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
That's good for a Denver Broncos.
Another good carry there for the NFL's second leading rusher. And we've talked on air, off air about his MVP candidacy. Make a case for him.
Well, I'm just going to tell you point blank, it doesn't matter whether he's first or second or even third in the league in rushing yardage. That's not the main deal. It's how he gets those yards and the impact he has on his ball.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Second down, ball on the 3. First down, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. Philip Lindsay. Touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Broncos will extend their lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment. That allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Now this will make it into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan, or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now the throw here complete on the right sideline. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
Out of bounds.
Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4.
Brings up second.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Von Miller in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
10 yards. And it's third down.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
14. Bills nothing.
Third and long, it's Allen. And this is going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
Kareem Jackson on
this offense has definitely been slow getting out of the gate.
It's almost like they missed their wake-up call for this one. No points on their first two possessions, and now it's looking like none on this one either.
A good kick that time, but also a pretty good 15-yard return. Now the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Lock in the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at their own 43. He'll start things with a handoff to Lindsey. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Trent Murphy made the tackle. It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5.
On second down, a run with Lindsey. And he'll be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 44.
That's good for a Denver
Broncos. It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
Out quickly to Judy. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down.
1st and 10 at the 28-yard line.
On first down, Locke. This is the tight end fan. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. They'll run with Lindsey. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up 2nd and goal.
Leads to
another shot from the 9 on 2nd and goal. Shotgun snap to Locke. And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown Broncos. Cortland Sutton. His 3rd touchdown now on the air. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. As that's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Bills as we take a look at the playoff race in the AFC. And it's right about this time of the year that you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go, but still plenty to be determined.
It certainly is, because we all know everyone is aiming for that number one seed. But failing that, because only 2 teams in the NFL get a bye, 1 from each conference, that question becomes, who's hot? Who's peaking at the right time as you start the playoffs?
Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
Third down.
The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. And that's caught by Beasley. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
To Cole Beasley. A gain of 19 yards.
And I don't think there's any question that this offense is going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try to wait until the half, it's probably too late. They need to get going right here.
In 2nd and inches.
In need of only about the length of the football here on 2nd down. They'll run out of the gun with Singletary. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or 2 shy of the 30. It's a 1st down on a gain of 10. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
Allen's throw is complete. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 12-yard line. He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down. On first down, Allen to the end zone, but it's incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown. And it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. Singletary here running out of the gun. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. The Bills on third down, just one for three thus far. This is third and 11. From the gun, it's Allen. And it's caught. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Stephon Diggs. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bills get a bit closer. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays, and it ends in a Buffalo touchdown. K.J. Hamler returning it. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard
line. Philip Lindsay and the rest of the offense heading back out. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here, because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, he really done some damage in an NFL game.
And now he's looking just to add to his totals. Here's second and 10 now from the 29. To throw again. Lock. We're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Teron Johnson able to pick it, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
A good pickup there, a 22. This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Von Miller in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
It's third down and goal.
From the gun, Allen. He hits Beasley right side. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Just a five-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. You're kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
Drew Lock once again leads the Broncos out. He has not been on his A game, but his team has really picked him up. I think he probably now, second quarter, he's thinking, all right, time for me to get going.
And he also has to keep it.
He rifles one that's intercepted. The all-pro corner, Tre'Davious White, picks it off. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take.
He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Jarrell Casey, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Shot well upfield across the 45. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Okay, Brandon, time for a sprint to the finish, as it's time to get you caught up with what's happening around the NFL here in a pivotal Week 15. Next, we'll head over to check on the Giants at home at MetLife Stadium. And they've gone to the half in that ball game with the visiting Browns out on top. Nick Chubb, a touchdown run in that first half. Lastly, let's head up to the Twin Cities to check in on the Vikings at home in Minneapolis. And they've got the lead over the visiting Chicago Bears. Kirk Cousins has fired three touchdown passes. In the game you're watching, it's been Drew Lock with a strong first half. His guys have the lead, as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Joey
Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter three is underway. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And last time was a pretty one play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happened.
Brings up second.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Another run by Lindsey. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
He's taken down at the 30.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive line, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
Lindsey on the carry.
Tackle made there by Matt Milano.
At the 40-yard line.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Locke's throw caught by Sutton, and he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 42. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
First and 10.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 42-yard line. Tremaine Edmonds, the Bills' leading tackler in 2019, in on the stop. Here's second and five now from the 37.
Brings up second.
They'll go again with Lindsey, and he'll be taken down at the 30. 40, a pickup of about four.
Tremaine Edmonds on the.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. Lock on the give. It's Lindsey. And only able to muster a couple down to about the 27. Now a stoppage here as we've got a Bill shaking up on the play. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. On second down. It's Lindsey. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
Another Denver Broncos.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now it's Lindsey. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Brings up third and two.
Third and two. Lock's going to throw. he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down. Vic Fangio, an old school coach, but he's going to go for it here on fourth. They'll go for it. It's Locke. And Locke throws another one. It's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Could you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
First down.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line.
He's taken down at the
couple of Broncos there in on the tackle.
Two. Brings up second and eight.
From the 17, Allen. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
8 yards to go.
Operating from the gun, Allen. The open man is Smith. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 15 yards that time, and a Buffalo first. They'll run on first down. Singletary. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about six.
He was brought down at the 45-yard line. A 6-yard pickup brings up second and four.
From the 45 on second down, Allen.
Well, coming into this one, we expected that this offense would have trouble with this defense, and that's exactly the way that this game has gone. Pressure in his face, coverage downfield has been tight. That led to another incompletion. This defense, they're exactly who we thought they were coming into this one.
Allen finding Brown for a Bills first down.
And the Bills first down.
Here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll run here with Singletary. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four.
Singletary.
Line of scrimmage, the 24. This is second and six.
A gain of four. It's now second and six.
A shotgun handoff down to Yeldon. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
He's tackled at the 32-yard
line. Nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down.
And it's third down.
From the gun, Allen. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25.
A gain of seven. First down, Bills.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Allen with a throw caught by Beasley. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down.
8 yards on the
facing
pickup.
A second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
17-yard line.
Operating from the gun. Allen. This will be caught just inside the 10. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
At the 7-yard line.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And again, it's Allen. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
Ball carrier.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. From the gun. Is caught for a Bills touchdown. Lee Smith with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Bills have cut it to within a score. There was
was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Well, I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion, and now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
Josh, you said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top five offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've got an answer for it.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. They'll keep it on the ground. Lindsay, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. On first and 10, it's Lindsay. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That one going for a gain of 11 there, and a Bronco first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he works his way forward from about four up to the midfield stripe.
He was taken down by...
I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of 2 on the play. Brings up
this a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and 4. Locke working out of the gun. Flushed out right. He's got his 6'5 receiver. That's Tim Patrick. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. A nice first down pickup on a gain of 6. On first down, it's Lindsay. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
A gain of a
yard. We're at the 41, second and 9. They'll keep it on the ground. Lindsay.
Philip Lindsay, the ball.
The objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but it works a lot.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. He'll get this to Philip Lindsay, complete. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 16. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Shotgun snap and a give to Lindsay. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. But they'll employ the jumbo set now on second and 1. Back to throw. Lock. The quick slant caught. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Jeff Heilman, his second touchdown on the season. And the Broncos push further out in front.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative.
Packers come to the line to start their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
To throw is Allen. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Jarrell Casey in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Jarrell Casey in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they got trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
He's going to let it fly. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about Slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
And he's going to go down. He's sacked back at the 24. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. They'll actually throw it with Locke, escaping the pressure right. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long, eluding the pressure right. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
31, Bills 18.
So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away into fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
So good field position for the Bills as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Now a desperation throw deep, and that's caught inside the 35. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. Give him 30 yards there. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. This will be caught inside the 10. And they move this all the way down to the 9.
Today's final score.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. So this one will wind up a Denver victory, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of. But now, it's about taking the ball away, taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for the Broncos, they continue to roll as the win gets them to 12-2 on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, for Buffalo, they drop their 10th game now to fall to 4-10. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Foxborough to face off against the New England Patriots. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin.